Hi friends, welcome back to a concluding session of oscillators. In the previous session, we have seen how a tank circuit can be used to build an oscillator that produces sustained oscillations. Let us look at the same concept with a physical example. Let us take example of a swing. A swing is a system which is hung from a pivot and it is allowed to swing, and the concept of swinging is, so the whole process begins when this is pulled one side, and once it is pulled on side, because of the length of this connecting system is fixed one, therefore this gets elevated, and this elevation causes increase in potential energy in the swing. Similar to our initial condition where we started with our capacitor charged, that means capacitor was having a potential energy, and because this is not a minimum potential possible and hence it wants to be with a minimum potential state, therefore it starts moving downwards. But as it starts moving downwards, it gets accelerated, and by the time it reaches the minimum potential energy position, it has sufficient velocity, and because of which the momentum will not allow this to stop here, and it continues further, and the kinetic energy gets stopped the moment when the whole kinetic energy gets converted back into another potential energy. This potential energy will not allow the swing to stay here, therefore it continues its reverse journey, and by the time it comes here, has gained momentum, cannot stop here, so continues back forth, the oscillation starts. So there are some disturbances in the system, like on this pivot there is friction, and this whole system is in the air, and hence there will be air friction, and which is taking away some part of the energy in this system, and hence the oscillations keep decaying with time. So what actually we do to confirm that the swing does not stop as it is happening here, so we don't want swing to stop, otherwise the child may break its sleep, so we don't want to disturb the child's sleep, and to ensure that child doesn't get disturbed, we must ensure that this oscillation must continue on and on and on. But in reality, this is what is happening. Then what actually we do to overcome this problem is, now and then we give a push to this. So thereby any energy lost will be pumped in. So we keep pumping energy by giving a push to the swing now and then. Done? Yes, that way a mother ensures that the child's swing keeps swinging on and on without any breaking. Now the question is, when should we apply this pumping energy? So should we run behind the swing? Definitely no. A very small fraction of energy is required that is lost in this friction. So if you keep pumping that small energy which is lost, then this continues to swing with the full length, and hence the swing action will be undisturbed. That is one thing. So we don't have to run behind all the time. Just stay here, give a small push. The next question is, when should we give the push? So should we give the push when the swing is approaching us, or when the swing stops at this position and by the time it starts moving, should we give the push? Yes, you understood it right. The push has to be given when the swing stops at its extreme position and is about to return its journey. At that time, just give a push. That means we need to know where the swing is, when it is stopping at its extreme position, when it is starting its reverse journey. Yes, we should know it. Without knowing it, it is not possible to do. So just imagine that the mother is trying to push the swing with her eyes closed. Is it possible? Maybe possible, but not without disturbing the swing. So sometime she may push the swing when it is approaching her, and that disturbs the swing action. Or she may try to push it when the swing is here, so she will not have the swing in her reach, so she cannot apply the energy to the swing. So in all, what is required is the mother has to know when exactly the push has to be given. So two things to be noted here. One thing, a small part of the cycle has to be used for pumping in the energy. Second thing is, we should know when to pump the energy. That means we need a feedback. Yes, we need a feedback, and that feedback we have gone either by breaking the inductor into two parts and creating the third point to get the feedback, or we can break the capacitor into two parts and create the third point to get the feedback. So these are the two things to get the feedback. Second thing is, we need a small cycle of the oscillation to be used for pumping the energy. That means we need some amplifier which works for very small part of the cycle. That means very much less than half cycle. So therefore we need a class C amplifier here, and we need a third point for feedback. So it can be either created this way, which we called Hartley oscillator, or we may create it like this, which is called a Colpitt oscillator. Then I hope now the concept is very clear why we use this type of circuitry. Yes, the potential energy is stored in the capacitor, and the kinetic energy is stored in the inductor, and this whole action we had seen in our previous lecture, that the current keeps oscillating to and fro because of electric magnetic field interactions, and same thing, the potential kinetic energy interactions, this is happening. So that's it for now. So we are through our second section. So we have seen what rectifier is, what amplifier is, and finally we have seen what an oscillator is. So as of now, it's time to end section 2. So in the coming lecture, let us start our section 3, which is more interesting, which speaks of more complex circuitry and makes the things more simpler to work with. So till then, take care. See you. Bye.